So in honor of the fact that we have an actual songwriter on the show today, Miss Amanda Lopiccolo, I thought that we would take a look at some more deleted Disney songs. Once again, we're going back to Aladdin, which was recently remade and released. I still have feelings about this remake, but anyway, those aside, other than Alice in Wonderland, Frozen, and perhaps Mary Poppins, Aladdin has more songs in its deleted catalog than almost any other Disney movie. Tonight we'll be talking about probably my favorite out of these deleted songs, High Adventure, a call to action song as Aladdin and his street rat friends, Babcock, Omar, and Kasim, whose names obviously just roll off the tongue, go off on a high adventure to defeat Jafar, essentially being the Kill the Beast song of Aladdin. Now that you guys have heard this piece, how do you guys feel about High Adventure?
That song, bro. That song. The first thing that came to mind when I heard it was an old school commercial that they did back in the day where the guy just kept repeating, "Real men of genius." That was what came to mind whenever I'm hearing this High Adventure. It brought back to mind those Saturday mornings when I'm sitting down watching cartoons, man. This was Aladdin and Friends, straight up. We are playing music while we're fighting. Like, that is just, there's so much to unravel, man. I'm just going to stop. I'm stopping.
I just have to point out two things real fast. A, oddly enough, the very, very first YouTube video I ever made 4 years ago, I made one with Kyle Nash. And it was a sports spoof of Real Men of Genius called Real Men of Awesome. Definitely check it out. It's in the links below. And secondly, you mentioned that line, playing music while we're fighting. According to Howard Ashman and Alan Menken, that was kind of the point of this song. They wanted to see if they could have an action scene during a musical number. It would have been interesting to see how this played out. But before we get to that, Amanda, your initial reaction, I heard it, was that this was the, what was it, goobiest song you've ever heard?
The goobiest song I have ever heard.
One more time, it's High Adventure. I hope the stallions are then beating with all his wisdom and we're leading.
My finger's bleeding.
Well, that's High Adventure.
You don't even need to see the scene to know what's happening. It's literally a narration of them just doing the same thing over and over again.
Yeah, but how many times do you hear a narration where the narrator's finger is bleeding?
I actually didn't catch that. I was just so caught up in the idea of the song itself. It was... I'm just sitting here trying to picture, you know, Aladdin and Friends and how much the story would have changed.
This comes from an early version of Aladdin where Aladdin was kind of depicted on the younger side. He lived with his mother, who was always disappointed in him. He had his three street rat friends. The Broadway play, oddly enough, is more closely related to that earlier version. They include some of these earlier songs. They include the three street rat characters. The one thing that provides a more of a linear path between that earlier version and the final version is the suggested orchestration of this song. It sounds very, very much like it's within that universe. And there are a lot of similarities mm-hmm. between the instrumental and the music that is played during some of the action scenes in Aladdin, the escape from the Cave of Wonders, the final battle with Jafar has a lot of High Adventure within its DNA.
Thank you.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
I hear you.
You can tell.
Totally hear you, bro. But let's look at Aladdin, okay? A whole new world. You ain't never had a friend like me. High anxiety, high adventure. It doesn't fit. Like, those other songs, Aladdin only had four songs in the whole movie.
Five, boom.
All
of
them
were Street Rat.
Street Rat. My bad. I apologize.
Uh-huh. That's like one of the best songs.
Five songs and three reprises.
You can't replace any of those songs. And if you put this high maintenance, high adventure, if you put high adventure in there, it just completely ruins the score. Don't do that. That's shenanigans.
See, and I don't think it was a terrible song. Like, it definitely wasn't their best work. But as if they were to place it right, no one would even pay attention to what the song was actually saying because they'd be so caught up in the high energy of the fight.
I compare it to Pocahontas and Beauty and the Beast on purpose. If you take a look at those other two songs, Savages or Kill the Beast, the songs that are prelude to action.
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me.
The skin's a hellish red. They're only good when dead. They're vermin, as I said, and worse.
There's high adventure in the air, guys. Someone's out there, guys. Someone that
attaboy master let on it.
He's got a damsel in despair, guys. Heck, that's not fair, guys. And I'm mad.
Very good, master. Gnash those teeth.
They're not the most memorable songs from that movie. Their whole design is to get you pumped up for what is to come. And High Adventure, I can see falling within that mold in a way.
And it's for children too. You know, you have to remember what your audience is. A lot of times when you're trying to cater to an audience, you really have to pay attention to what they like. And little kids, when I was a little kid, did I understand most of what was happening in any of the musical scenes? Absolutely not. I was not paying attention to the music. I was paying attention to the feeling that the music gave me. So maybe I'm a weird kid, but I mean, they're really going to, they would probably love that song because they can relate to it and it's so simple.
And it would once again expand their vocabulary and pronunciation when they're singing along to Babcock, Omar, and Kasim.
And they're going to love that friendship too. You know, all kids want to feel included, and to see friendships on screen. I mean, that's why some of our favorite TV shows and movies are our favorite TV shows and movies, because we really just want that to be what our life is like.
The line from this song that I just cannot shake is when we're playing music while we're fighting. Like, that right there, that line just makes this thing hit home. And I said, I can imagine my boys, like, my two sons, I can imagine them saying that line and actually, you know, play fighting with each other. So to Piccolo's point, absolutely. Pandering to your audience fits right here. Kids would love that song. I, though, this guy, I can't see myself downloading that one and playing it in the car. And look, I've been jamming to Let It Go for years.
Oh, hell.
But high adventure would not be played in the truck. It can't happen.
It kind of breaks that fourth wall too a little bit.
Yeah.
Which is another reason that I think that kids would like it.
Aladdin, though, you're right. Aladdin in many instances does break the fourth wall. Hell, the genie actually rips the screen apart at one point. You know, beckoning you to look. So there are, it seems that despite the fact that this is from a much earlier version of the film, it fits contextually with how the film feels, the finished product feels, except just the characters, most of them are gone. I think those characters in many ways took away a little bit from Aladdin. I think it makes him a much more tragic character that he is by himself. Mm-hmm. His only friend is a monkey who, my God, I mean, if you were going to have a pet monkey, I want to have one that's skilled in breaking me out of prison. That's a good thing to have.
I wanted Abu so bad when I was little.
I had a little stuffed Abu that I got with the DVD.
Aww.
That was stolen from me. Somebody stole my Abu. And one of these days, I'm going to find this perpetrator.
some common street rat.
Some street rat stole my stuffed monkey.
No, I remember not even being able to find the DVD when it came out. I kept it on VHS just because of that movie.
I got it on VHS as well. Look, if I can try and make this thing work, we got the three friends. One of them's name is Omar. So if you can get the Omar from The Wire to play as this guy, then I'm totally in, because when you come at the king, you best not miss.
I have no argument for this.
Boom.
Hell, give the carpet a voice and have him sing along. I'd love to. He probably sounds like Jack Nicholson.
You know what? You can make the carpet sound like that guy who sings Chocolate Rain.
Oh my gosh. Yes, that would be even better.
Chocolate Rain.
For something so flat, it has such strong baritone. It's fantastic.
Right. That's why it would be so weird, because you wouldn't expect something. I mean, first off, you don't expect the carpet to sing at all. But when the carpet spreads its little flappers, I can't even say lips because it doesn't have a mouth. When it spreads its flappers and then you get Chocolate Rain, I mean, there's not going to be dry panties in the house.
It'd be a whole new world.